Hey, so this is Pramit. Awesome. Hey guys, are you able to see my screen? Can one of you please respond on the chat box, please?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. Awesome. Hey, so like I said, for the people who've joined newly, we will begin in exactly a minute. Okay. So guys, while people are joining in, thank you again, everybody, for joining in. So can we take a minute to introduce ourselves? So in the chat box, let's go ahead and write our names as well as the place that we are from. I can begin. Can all of us just introduce ourselves quickly? Okay, awesome. Thank you, everybody, for introducing yourselves. It's good to see you all. Hopefully, we'll have a good session today. It's 11:04. We'll begin in exactly a minute. Awesome. So can I request everybody to please mute themselves? And if you have a question, definitely unmute yourself to ask the question, or even feel free to use the chat box. Okay. Awesome. So I see a lot of introductions. Thank you, everybody, for introducing yourself. And with that, we, let's make this session very interactive. So let's begin. I think we are at 11:04. So we'll begin the session and hopefully people will join in soon enough. Okay, so before we begin, quickly introducing myself here. This is Pramit. I'm a software engineer by profession, but a mentor by passion. I have been mentoring students for a few years now. I love to teach students to share my whatever knowledge and experience I have. And we are starting this series, which we do every Saturday in the evening, and I invite all of you to come join this session. The objective of this session is only one, and that is to enable you guys to do well in your career, to plan it well, to plan it in a way so that you exactly do what you love and to reach new heights, right? So because Indian student community, I feel, is very not so well placed in the terms of being mentored, being knowing what's going on in the industry, right? In fact, in the last sessions, our focus was completely that, as to what exactly are we doing wrong, right? We are first learning coding without knowing where are we going to apply it, without having any vision for our life, right? And we discussed many big problems that Indian students have. Like they don't have financial literacy, right? We don't know how much money do we need in the first 5 years to be able to plan our careers, to be able to take risks, to be able to create a startup of our own, right? We are very insecure, right? So we are lacking at a lot of perspectives, but I feel that with a little bit of mentorship, little bit of sharing of our experiences, we can do very well. We can enable ourselves to take a lot of risk that we are not taking today, right? We can plan ahead our career a lot more than we are doing today. So with that intent, we are starting this series, and I invite all of you to come join every Saturday evening, because I'm also, you know, busy during the day. So Saturday evening it is, and I invite all of you to come join this session. And feel free to ask any question that you have. Feel free to propose sessions, because I'm here only to help you. Right. So with that intent, feel free to propose a session as well. Okay. Awesome. So with that, so this is me. I was able to give a good introduction of myself, but if you have any specific question, feel free to go ahead and ask them. I request all of you to kindly mute your mics just so that we are focused, right? So today's session, what is the topic of today's session, right? Is how do we learn faster and more effectively, right? How do we learn faster and more effectively? So, but before we begin today's session, I have a bunch of things that I want to share. And this is mostly from my experience over the many years, right? So we will have a good discussion today. And I will try to share as much experience and knowledge as possible with you guys. But before we begin, if you have some notion of what this session is going to be like, what are you going to learn from this session? What do you want to learn from this session? Can you please go ahead and write in the chat box? What are you expecting? Right? Just so that it's there for my reference for later. I see that Ashok is raising his hand. Okay. If you have something, Ashok, feel free to. Memory techniques. Good. Okay. Revising techniques. Okay. Feel free to guys go ahead and put your thoughts in the chat box. Let's make it interactive. Shankanil is saying mind mapping. Okay. Krishna is saying, hey, welcome back guys who were there in the previous session. I see a lot of names that I know. So effective methods for more productivity. Good. And taking leap steps in less time. Very good. How to focus. Very good. Definitely. So all of these we are going to discuss. Effective avoiding procrastination. Okay. Good thought, Navjeevan. So it's not something on my radar, because today we are going to focus completely on learning. But maybe something for our future sessions, right? Gaurav is saying study techniques during COVID-19. Okay. Aman is saying how to do smart work. Okay, we'll try to focus on how to do smart learn. Definitely. Suraj is saying lack interest due to without knowing. Very good suggestion. Definitely we are going to focus on that. SN is saying correct time to learn correct thing. Very good. I think this is indirectly something that we're going to focus on. Okay. So for whoever shared their thoughts, thank you. Appreciated, right? So let's with that go into our session. So the first question that I'm posing you guys, right? But before I pose you this question, can we first define what learning is? What is learning? Can anybody take a stab? Feel free to respond on the chat box. What is learning? What do we mean by learning? A way of flowering. Flowering? What is flowering, Krishna? Should I call you Krishna or Kaushik? I'm calling you Krishna, but feel correct me if you want me to.
Getting to know something so that we can use it daily. Okay. Or maybe in the future.
Okay. To know something that we can use in the future. Okay. Thank you, Krishna. And thank you. Was it Yogesh or who just spoke just now?
This is Sumit.
Sumit. Thank you, Sumit. Okay, but Yogesh, can you please mute yourself? Pawan is saying getting information which can be used in future. Okay, very good. So, to master some skill. Very good. Very good. Shibadatta is saying to master some skill. Very good. But I will define, before we begin, right, what is learning? How do you learn fast? I need to define that for this session, right? So, thank you for responding. So, let's define learning for this session. And we will have a very fundamental definition. Learning is, I am defining it as, and let me know if you agree or not, transmission of an idea or a fact from one brain to another. One part of learning. The second part of learning is creation of a new idea. I'll repeat. Transmission of one idea from one brain to another. Like when I'm reading, the author is transmitting his ideas to my brain, right? I'm indirectly. Yeah, Ashok. Yeah, Akash, go ahead. Somebody was saying something? Sure. So let me complete this point. It is that any way you learn, right? When you are learning, when you're reading, you are getting the ideas of the author into your brain. When you are discussing in the classroom, then the ideas of the teacher, whatever it might be, like somebody said for daily skill, somebody said talking to learn, to use it in the future, right? Whatever the reason might be, whatever. But when I'm saying I'm learning, basically I'm transferring some idea from somebody else's. It might be my friends, my teachers, my colleague, from their brain to my brain. That's how I learn, right? Or I create a new idea. That's also a way to learn. I'm creating not from somebody else, but from myself, because I created that new idea. Like Newton created the law of gravity, right? So he did not learn it from somebody else, but he created, he thought of some idea. And I'm sure all of us think of some idea or the other. Sometimes we think of some idea and we put it in our Facebook status or LinkedIn status, right? So any thoughts here? So what I want to, and why am I emphasizing this? Why did I define this? I defined this so to acknowledge, right? So, and creation of idea is like less than 1%. Let's agree, right? Creation of idea by ourselves is less than 1% of learning. So 99% is transmission of some idea or concept or fact from some other brain through a book, through a blog, through a video, through an audio, through a discussion to our brain. So acknowledge that we are getting it from somebody else. Mostly we are not acknowledging that, right? So you need to acknowledge the author, the teacher, the friend, the colleague from where you are getting the knowledge. Acknowledge that at 99% of time, I'm getting those ideas from somebody else. These are not my ideas. Only 1% of time I'm creating my own ideas. But 99% of time I'm getting it from somebody else. So if I have to learn something fast, you have to work with those somebody else, right? So imagine when there were no books, you could not buy anything from books. You had to go to the teacher's ashram and stay there. And then you enable transmission of ideas, right? So learn that learning is also interacting with others, because that's the way you will learn from others, right? So with this definition, I want you to also recognize one thing, that all of us have some things that we have in the past learned very fast, very efficiently, very quickly. And there are some things for all of us, which we haven't learned quickly, which we faced difficulty in learning. It could be anything. It could be singing, could be learning to cycle. It could be to learn to play an outdoor sport, cricket, football, hockey. It could be to debate. It could be to do maths problems. It could be to write essays. It could be to remember historical facts. There are different things that we have learned in the past, right? So some things that we, all of us have learned fast, and some things that all of us have learned slowly. Before we try and think what are the reasons why, how can we learn things fast generally, can all of us acknowledge that there are things that all of us have learned really fast and all of us have learned really slow? So I would like all of you to think of something in the past that you have learned really fast, right? You are very good at learning. It could be anything, and type it in the chat box, because you can learn from yourself. Why did you learn that very fast, right? So think of something that you were very good at, you learned very fast or very quickly, and write it on the chat box. Okay. Sumit, programming. Shankhanil, maths. Gaurav, maths. Okay. Riding a bike. Driving. See, very innovative answer, driving. So what does that mean? Driving is something that requires a lot of sensory coordination, right? Hand-eye coordination, control over my physique, right? So you need to whip in, realize that some, that is your strength, hand-eye coordination, sensory, maybe moving fast, right? Excitement. So maybe that, those are your strengths. So whatever you learned really fast, they will point towards some of your strengths, right? Learning new words, right? Good. Many of us actually. So learning a language, it's a mixture of art and science and logic, right? Very good example, Sahas. Pawan is saying math, English word meaning. English word meaning, again, mixture of logic and memory. So it points towards your strength. Remember your answer. We will refer to your answer later on throughout the session, right? Ashok is saying dance. See, dance is very good example. Like it points to your physical ability, right? Like learning cycle points to your neural ability plus physical ability. Dance is your artistic ability plus physical ability. So know your strengths, right? SN is saying whatever we are interested in. Okay, good. So whatever we are passionate at, that makes sense. Imagination. Einstein was very good at imagination. Thought experiments, he said, right? He just would sit and imagine things. Not everybody is good at it. Then there is different kinds of imagination. Spatial imagination. I can imagine 3D objects. That's called spatial imagination. Not everybody is good at that. Some people are like 2D imagination or I forget the name of it. So there are different kinds of imagination, different kinds of memory. Like how do you ride cycle? That's also kind of memory, right? So different types of things that all of us, painting, right? Painting is what? Logic, your creativity, a lot of things, right? Painting is your strength. Aishwarya is saying painting, drawing, very good. So that is, drawing and painting are creativity plus logic, right? And imagination, right? Sketching, right? So Saurabh is saying sketching, very good. Sketching again, maybe to some extent physical dexterity plus imagination plus... So I hope that you get a sense of what you are naturally good at or you like or you're passionate about, right? So there are things that you learned very well and we will go into why, right? And we'll break that down. Now I saw a lot of passion, right? For me, dance is most difficult. Gaurav, I'm coming there. That's my next question. Krishna is saying, whatever we care for. Exactly, right? We will dissect this further. Why do you learn something fast? And how can you apply the same logic to something else? Now, before we learn how do we learn fast, let's everybody write something that we did not learn fast. Let's acknowledge that for everybody, so nobody here is a god. Everybody has something that we did not learn fast, right? So let's go ahead and write that. Cooking, okay. Navjeevan, very creative answer. Maths, good. Inorganic chemistry points to memory to some extent and to some extent logic also, right? Aishwarya, maths. Maths is again a little bit of art, creativity and also logic, right? It's a mixture of things. So maybe you are just good at maths, just good at creativity, but maybe a little bit not so good at creativity plus art, right? But actually it's not necessarily that you are bad at it. We'll go into detail. Like there is one example where you did not learn something very well, but it's actually not necessarily true that you are naturally bad at it. There may be other reasons. We will dissect those, right? Shankaran is saying social skills, very good example, somewhat applicable to me also. Ashok is saying language, good. Right, so you're acknowledging something about you. There is no shame in acknowledging. Acknowledge history. History points probably towards memory. By the way, I'll give one example. History, I hated history when I was in school, but right now I'm a very big fan of history. I have studied history from history of everything, history of art, history of maths, history of computer science, history of India, Europe, Persia, Ottoman, that is Turkey, right? So I study a lot of history. So there is a transformation. But when I was in school, I absolutely hated history. There must be some reason, right? Why I hated then and I love now. We'll go into that. Poetry, good. Poetry you couldn't master, good. Science subjects, good. Did not learn fast. Public speaking, good. And there could be different reasons for that. We'll go into reasons. But thank you everybody for responding with something that you learned very fast and some things that you did not learn very fast, right? And this you remember, keep in your mind throughout the session, right? and try to root cause. Okay. So let's also acknowledge there is nobody who is genius at everything, right? There is nobody who is genius at everything. You are good at learning something, a little bit not so good at learning some other thing. Okay, cool. Now we will go into a little bit of why. And I want to hear from you, right? Why do you think you learned some things very fast and did not learn some other things so fast? Can I hear some thoughts? So I have three things that I am going to tell you. But before I'm sure many of you are going to say those three things also. But we'll dissect those three points individually. But can I hear thoughts from you? Why do you think that thing that you learned very fast, you learned so fast, and that thing that you did not learn very fast, why you did not learn that very fast? Never interested. We enjoyed that. Very good point. You enjoyed that. Never felt interested. Same, almost same. Lack of interest. Good. Because of interest. Good. Ashok, thank you. Rohit, thank you. Krishna, disliking it instantly. Okay. So I'm getting one very strong point. That is interest. Okay. Some might take time. Some might not. Okay. This is another point. Time and might not. Okay. Lack of interest and concentration. Very important point, lack of interest. And another point coming out is concentration, right? Okay. Society's influence. Very good point, Pawan. Very, very good point. Society's influence. So a lot of people said maths. What is really maths? What's the definition of maths? Who defined maths? Right? That society is influenced because you are pressure. We are naturally taught that there is something called maths. You just play around with numbers, play around with this, and you need to be good at it. So we think that, okay, we need to be good at, right? So lack of consistency, okay. Lack of patience, good. Motivation, right? Good. Lack of consistency, dopamine, okay. Shreya is giving a very creative answer here. Dopamine, right? So for everybody, dopamine is something that is a hormone that is secreted when you do something that you enjoy, right? Like when you eat chocolate, right? So when you say dope, right? When something is really nice, you say it's dope. So it basically comes from dopamine, like something that you really enjoy. So obviously something like when I actually used to learn, like when I'm also an artist, I paint, I've also had exhibitions. So when I'm really stressed out, I come from office, I paint for 1 hour, I can't tell you, like so much of dopamine flow that all my stress is gone, right? So something that really soothes you, right? And I obviously did not take any time for me to just jump into art and learn about art history, impressionism, post-impressionism, fauvism, pixelism, right? And not just read about it, go do it. Okay, something that doesn't interest me, good. Thinking that one will teach that thing and we will begin that thing, we will not begin that thing by our own self. Okay, interesting point from Suraj here. Not knowing need of learning something at the time of learning. Very good point, need of learning. We'll come to this, we will discuss this in detail. One was interest. A little bit, another point was focus, and there was societal pressure, need of something, which is also related to societal pressure, right? Because maths is a need of our society. Why? Read maths, otherwise you are not going to get a job, right? That's a societal pressure or need, okay? Father's profession or family's priority, again, sort of like societal pressure, right, Pawan? Like something external influence. You need to know why, if your father kar rahe to, should I also go ahead and do it, right? Or father kar rahe, so maybe let me go ahead and do it. Yaar. Already there is, we're making money in that business. Why not? Both ways, right? Meet is saying, learn something, you need to necessarily learn it. Okay. Necessity. Ananya is saying lack of interest, concentration, determination, right? Patience, which is almost like focus or to get to be persistent, right? We'll discuss that a little bit. Fast. Learning new words as a kid, completely new activity, interest to know more, right? So Sahas is saying, his natural interest is to know more. And there are people like that. In fact, I have also that kind of inclination to know like a little bit about everything, right? And Sahas is saying slow is public speaking. For starters, I was an introvert. Very good. So that is your natural interest again coming out, right? Krishna is saying consistent commitment. Very good point. We will come to that. Krishna, we will also come to that. Like why, right? There is a why. It's again going back to need. Let's say your need is ki bhai, I have to do something spectacular. Like maybe Mukesh Ambani thought, yaar, Dhirubhai did all this, but I need to do something spectacular in my Reliance business. So that's again constant commitment. Example of constant commitment, right? Being influenced by people and creating a mindset. Very good, Ishika. So I see that so many points, once you start thinking about it, right? So many points are coming in. So we'll analyze, or I'll share my experiences on 3 points, and which are again more or less coming out from this discussion. So the first point is this, right? Why are you doing what you are doing? Right? When you are learning a thing, first question is, why are you learning? Last weekend, for those who were there, we discussed a principle called why, and then what, and then how. So don't learn coding first. First, you decide why are you learning coding, or why are you doing what you're doing. Then decide what are the things that you want to do towards that why. And once you have closed a bunch of whats, only then go into what. Only then learn coding. Only then learn a new language. Only then learn how to speak publicly, right? First why, then what, and then how. And it is also applicable to learning. To give an example, let's say you, I'm sure there must be one subject which all of you hated, some subject, right? To give my example, I hated history when I was a student. And that is because I didn't know what was the point. And I am getting many examples from you, right? What is the need? You need to know, let's say coding. Many of us, when we read it in our first semester or second semester, many of us actually are not told, ki bhai, why? In fact, a dozen years from now, when I was a student, today we know that if you are good at coding, you'll get a very good placement, right? But in our days, we didn't know that, because the placements were not like, IT industry was not that huge, right? So then coding, most of the people were very disinterested in coding, and for a good reason. You have to first tell them why they need to learn it, right? And now apply this logic to what you were not so good at learning, or what you want to be good at learning, right? Ask yourself that. There was this subject, let's say there was this subject, let's say discrete maths. If you're a computer science student, you would have read discrete maths. Most of them, 90% of the teachers don't tell why is discrete maths useful? Where can you apply it? Why should you study it? Same for, I'm sure you can apply to many other subjects, formal languages and automata theory, PLAT, another subject that most teachers don't tell. And typically these kind of subjects are a little difficult to figure out by yourself, right? So now, whatever you said that you were bad at, now give yourself that reason. If you knew the advantage of that, like if, for example, I told you, if you are really good at coding, you will definitely get a good payment, good salary of, let's say, 10 lakhs plus. That would be a good motivation, right? Maybe you are still naturally not inclined, maybe, because many of you said that if I'm not interested, why will I learn? Right? But maybe you are still not interested, but if you are given a really strong why, you will still have a good motivation to go and spend your effort, time, energy towards learning that. Now I have put one point and I will pause here. I want to hear what you guys think about it. SN is saying how many whys and what can convince us to go for that thing. Okay. It's on you. Last session, I said that why, to figure out why, right? Give yourself a couple of years. Don't agree on the why immediately, because you know yourself. If I am a creative and a logical person, how can I contribute to my society? That's my why. For example, my why, I'll tell you, right? And be vocal about your why. Tell it to your friends and family. My why is to educate the Indian student community so that they are much more empowered. That's my why. That's the life goal for me. Doesn't matter what I'm doing, which company I'm in, where I'm staying, doesn't matter. That's a why for me. And what? There are many whats. I organize webinars, I try to mentor students, right? So there are many whats. But so your why is your why. You should not compare anybody else's why to your why, right? So once you agree that it is a good why for you, I promise you, you will learn it very, very well. There is no reason why you will not learn very well, right? At the same time, if you don't find a good why, maybe you should not learn it very well. Maybe you are trying 50 hours a week to try to learn something which you should not be learning because you are not really passionate about it, because there is no reason. There is no why for you to learn, right? Maybe there is no good reason. So why should you be spending so much energy in that? Okay. Okay. Cool. So I am reading some of your comments here, similar to architecture, why we are being taught life science. Okay. Okay. Exactly. So maybe you need to see, either you say this subject, right? And I think in our education system, right, this is a in fact, I am planning to host a webinar on education system, our education system. Why is it really, really wrong? And one major point is this, that Pawan pointed out. Like in around every, if I go into your engineering semester, right, we give around 40 odd hours to for a subject. But in my opinion, first 5 to 10 hours of that should be just to convince the student why should you learn this subject. And my personal opinion is that if you convince the student why, right, you don't even need to teach the rest 30 hours. He'll go learn by himself. Give him a strong why. Why should he learn that subject? And if you don't why, have a strong why, don't teach that subject. They don't deserve to spend so much 40 hours of their life learning that subject if you don't have a very strong why. Okay? So that's, I think, very good point, Pawan. Meet is saying there's an internal need to create something impactful, something beautiful. See, this is his personal why. Do you see? It's a strong. So now if I am giving a job to Meet, where he's going to be creating, he will get to create something impactful and something beautiful. You know, his motivation level will be sky high automatically because he knows his why, right? Okay. Gaurav is saying we should learn everything, whatever we are interested in. Yeah. So a very good why is your interest, your natural interest. If your natural interest is to create something creative, you automatically have that why. Sachin Tendulkar's natural instinct is to play cricket day in, day out. So he already has found his why. If you have a natural interest, then you already have found your why. Okay. And can I ask you one question? Just think about something. When you are learning something that you are really interested in, now think about whether when you are learning it, during learning, did you find it stressful or not? If you found it stressful, like, yaar, fir se ye problem karna padega. Yaar, fir se I have to remember this whole chapter, right? Or I'm going to learn so many things, right? So remember, when you are learning something, was it stressful or not? That's a good indicator for do you have a good why or not, right? So if you don't have a good why, but you want to learn it, let's say coding, let's say I am not naturally inclined to learn coding, let's say, right? But I must learn coding. I have decided that I will learn coding. I want that 15L package. Definitely. I have decided, right? I wouldn't recommend that to anybody because my recommendation is figure out a strong why for your life that we discussed last session. But let's say you have decided that you want to learn something fast, but you are finding that you are not so good at it. First tip, find out a very strong why. How do you find out? Go talk to your teacher. Go talk to your colleagues. Go talk to anybody who you think can give you a good why. Once you find a good why, you will definitely be much more motivated, right? The second point that I want to discuss today is what is your ability to learn? Right? Somebody said focus. Remember, Somebody said memory, remember? So what is your ability to learn, right? So what do I mean by ability? Can anybody take a stab here? What do I mean by ability to learn? Like somebody, many of us have faced this, right? I tried to remember it, but I forgot. What do I mean by ability to learn? What is the ability to learn? Is that a fixed thing or not? Does anybody want to take a stab at what is ability to learn? Take a stab, guys. Talent. Okay, talent in what? Somebody is talented at singing. Somebody is talented at playing sports. Somebody is talented.
Some people.
Yes, Sumit, go ahead.
Some people learn when they read something out to themselves. Like they have auditory memory more than they have visual memory. Some people have.
Awesome point. Awesome point. In fact, there is a dedicated discussion point on that also. We'll come to that. Very good point, Sumit.
Some people have visual memory more than they have other forms of memory. So different people learn the same things by different methods. Some people read a paragraph out to themselves. Some people create visual maps to learn the same thing.
Awesome. So do you see what Sumit is saying here? I will tell you one thing, that I myself was in the same boat. I'm not blaming anybody. Most of us, right, they don't even think about learning. We simply pick the book and start learning. We don't think about learning. We will cover this point in detail, actually. Right? So he talked about a very beautiful point, visual memory. Some of us have very strong visual memory. I read a book and I remember. And some of us have very strong verbal memory. Like if I read just by looking right, I'll not remember it. But if I say it aloud, speak it aloud, if I hear it myself, or hear it from a teacher, hear it from a colleague, I'll remember instantaneously, right? So different kinds of memory, we'll go to that. But I'll tell four things, right? In order to take this discussion. Okay, Shalini is saying capacity of taking in something. Okay, absolute willingness to learn. Okay, good. Sean and Connie is privately saying to me, comprehension, retention. Okay, very, very good. Comprehension is again, a sort of like processing a data set in your memory. Retention is memory, curiosity. Good. Meet is saying natural tendency to do something effortlessly. Okay, that's your natural ability to do something. What is that something, Meet? Maybe something is remembering.
Like some people can play games effortlessly, or some people are able to compute things like
math. Exactly. Very good point, right? So for different people, that something is different, right? But so that's why the capabilities are different. Good. Okay. Pavan is saying thoughts matches our interest, right? So, but let me try to condense the whole ability. There's something that we talked about into four categories, and let me hear from you whether you guys agree, disagree, or want to add on top of that. Okay, the first is memory. All of us have a hard disk. Let's accept that some people have a better hard disk and some people don't have a really good hard disk, right? And what to do about it, we'll see, we'll discuss, right? Some people have the second quality that I want to bring out to you guys is empathy. What is empathy? You can relate to some other person's emotion, right? Like if some other person is feeling sad, you want to really reach out and help them. So let's say somebody met with an accident on the road. Not everybody goes and helps them, right? Only some people do. So they are the people with high EQ, emotional quotient, right? So those are the people with high empathy. So again, some people have it naturally, some people don't have it for whatever reason. Maybe it's a upbringing, it's a family value, it's a society value, it's a national value, who knows, right? But for whatever reason, some people have it, some people don't have it. Third point that I would like to bring out is analytical ability. Somebody said comprehension. Comprehension is a mixture of two things, memory and analytical ability, right? But the third dedicated point that I want to bring out is analytical ability. Like given a data set, right? Some sort of data set. I want to take it in my mind, let's say, and retain it for 1 minute, 2 minutes, and then play around with that data. Like you must have seen in NTSC question, remember, an image is given. How will that image look if it is completely reversed? Some of us could easily answer that question, fatafat, and some of us couldn't, because we have that analytical. So some people again have visual analytical ability, some people have numeric analytic ability, some people have mnemonic or textual analytical ability. So there are different types of analytical ability, but I'll categorize them into one category called analytical ability, right? And the fourth ability is focus. I think it was Ishika or Shalini one told, right? Focus. So four ability. Now I'll repeat them for your benefit, and I want you to judge yourself, measure yourself on all four of these, and let's accept the fact everybody has one strong point or multiple strong points out of these, and everybody has somewhat weaker points: memory, empathy, analytical ability, focus. 4 points. Just to make sure that everybody is thinking on those lines, can everybody just point their strongest ability out of these? Memory, empathy, analytical ability, focus. Right in the chat box, right? What do you think is your strongest ability? Memory, empathy, analytical ability, focus. What is your strongest ability? Go ahead and write it down. What is your strongest ability? Memory, Sumit is saying memory. Good. Okay. What else? Who else? Empathy, Irene. Thank you, Irene. Shahas saying focus. Good. Pavan is saying analytical ability. Vivek is saying focus. SN is saying empathy. Suraj is saying analytic. Krishna is saying empathy. Ishika is saying analytical ability. Ashwa is saying analytical ability. Shalini is saying analytical ability. Shiba is saying focus. Shreya is saying focus and empathy. Sai is saying focus. Shankar is saying analytical memory, right? Empathy. So the intent is this. See, some machines, some laptops or mobile phones have high memory, or they have graphics card, memory dedicated for graphics, and low CPU. Some have very high CPU, less memory. Some have very high hard disk, less memory, less CPU. But different devices have different configuration. But their use cases is also different, right? Saurav is saying, I didn't understand how focus is coming here. I'll tell you. Focus is the second part. There are two types of learning we defined, right? One is you get your knowledge from somebody else. The second is you produce your own learning. You produce your own knowledge. That's where focus comes in. Do you think you can play competitively chess with Vishwanathan Anand? That's where focus comes in. Like what? So my definition of focus is you are able to take an idea, take it into your mind and play around with the idea without distraction for hours together. That's how I define focus. Not everybody can do it, right? So that's different from analytical abilities. You got a problem, you solve it in 5 minutes. Focus is something you got an idea and you're constantly thinking about an idea without getting distracted. Newton was so much focused. Newton, you know what Newton used to do? Newton used to observe the sky, because you know constellations, right? The division of the whole visible universe into parts, that's called constellations, right? In Hindi, we called it nakshatra. So he used to actually deduce the nakshatra just by looking at the sky, night sky, and he would be awake for the whole night. He remained awake for so many nights that he actually got a insomnia. He couldn't sleep. He got a disease. He got a mental breakdown from that, right? So that's what I meant by focus. He was so much focused. He was into it, right? So if you absolutely love doing something, right, you will be focused on it, like complete attention. If you, for example, I also love to play football. So if you just leave me on the football ground, I will play football for 3 hours. Nobody, without any distraction, nobody can pull me out from it, right? Different times of focus. But again, so guys, I did not hear. Okay. So next question. Out of the four, what do you think? This is a difficult question. Difficult question. What do you think is your weak point? Memory, analytical ability, empathy, or focus? Difficult question, but let's go ahead and try to answer that. Memory, good. Memory for me also. Focus, to some extent, me also focus. Analytical, memory, focus, analytical ability, and focus. suddenly focus sai analytical ability pavan short term memory okay as a memory focus memory Saurav sahas analytical ability Aishwarya memory good so the point is this accept your weakness right so once you accept your weakness you can do two things you can do something with that weakness let's say I didn't have legs would I ever target to go for a running race no right I'll go prepare for maths olympiad if I'm good at that right so two things from here once you know your strength and remember these four skills remember because these qualify you right just like you say in maths english history these are my marks so get some sort of marks in all these four fields and now you have acknowledged that I'm weak at something and that contributes towards you not being able to learn fast something whatever that something right now you have two paths one is to improve yourself on that whatever you are weak at all four of them are improvable all four of them memory definitely improvable empathy definitely improvable with a good coach we will go to that right in fact the next point is this and analytical ability definitely improvable focus definitely improvable right so two paths where I was right one is you can improve whatever you are good at or you can leverage whatever you are strong at for example let's say I'm strong at empathy I'm weak at analytical ability and focus I'm okay at memory let's say right so you are the right candidate to go and open an NGO or create a school or create a helpage facility right where aged people are so you are because if you do that you will reach heights that if I let's say somebody who has good analytical ability but less empathy I can never reach that even if I tried I will fail you will definitely beat me because you have natural empathy right and again use the mixture because it's not like you are really strong at something and really weak at anything you may not be really weak at anything but if you are really strong at something leverage that emphasize that and learn that more let's say you are really good at actually I left one ability here that is physical ability I left that out and I must correct that sorry for missing that out but if you are in fact let me take a note of that right away so that I should not miss it the next time right so according to you what is Shreya is asking what is ascending order there is no ascending order Shreya you have your strengths you have your weakness decide what how do you use your strengths your why of your life should align with your strengths right let's say your memory is really strong and let's say your analytical ability is weak but you are forcefully trying to learn good at maths but if you had focused more on spell bee or learning word spellings of words or history maybe you could have world champion but because you're trying to be good at really good at maths you are not so good at maths you are not so good at spelling or history right recognize your strength and use it and if you really want to improve your strength recognize your weakness find out how to improve it right the third point is anybody Shankhanil were you saying something no okay so the third point very important point that I also talked about in a last to last SN is asking what if someone has all 5 20% each if definitely there are a lot of people who are good at everything which is good you can do anything that you want you are right if you are good at everything you can do anything that you want and there may be some people who are bad at everything but that's okay right actually there is I have never seen who is bad at everything in my life I have never seen who is bad at all five of these memory empathy analytical ability focus and physical ability I have never seen a person who is bad at everything people who have physical ability you will automatically see that they have either very strong memory or very strong empathy right so mostly all of us have okay so SN maybe to you what I am I don't know your name feel free to write that if you want me to address with your correct name but what I am trying to say is that never mostly we have some strengths right so use your strengths or if you really want to improve acknowledge your weakness and then improve your weakness right So the third reason why we are not able to learn really fast. First was why, right? The second was our ability. Are we playing to our strengths or are we not playing to our strengths? The second point was that. The third point is who is teaching you. We had covered this point in our first session, right? And I will repeat that one important point. The best teacher, best student is always taught by the best teacher. I will repeat. The best student is always taught by the best teacher. Mediocre teachers can't produce best students. What do I mean by that? Now remember something that you learned really fast. All of you have that with you. Remember who was your teacher. And the teacher does not necessarily be your teacher. It could be a friend who, because you learned really good cricket, because you had a friend who was playing very good cricket and you learned from him while you were playing, right? So they don't need to formally teach you, by the way. Or in office, maybe you have a colleague who is doing that thing really well, that he's inspiring you. You are also learning things from them, right? So always, so never run away from people who are good at things that you are good at or you want to be good at. Never, to give a very relatable example. You might have in your class, let's say you are really good at science and there is another person who's good at science. You always have that feeling of competition, right? Maybe you don't even talk to them sometimes, right? Best teachers, because if you learn from them, you are going to be the best or you are going to get much better. As opposed to that, if you be friends with somebody who is not that good at what you want to be good at, you will never become better. So always get into the leagues of good teachers. Okay, not necessarily formal teachers, but people who are good at that and who are willing to teach you. And there may be people who are good at that, but they're not willing to teach you, right? So one, and in fact, this I will bring that at the end also. Always learn from the best teacher, right? Be Ekalavya. Ekalavya went around and found Dronacharya. Dronacharya was the best teacher. And because Dronacharya was the best teacher, Pandavas and Kauravas were the best of their time, right? And Ekalavya became the best by finding the best teacher. That's why people go to Kota. That's why people go to Narayana. Because they are the best teachers, right? It's there in our subconscious, it's there. But if it is not there in yours, or if you're not explicitly using it, start using it today. You want to learn coding? Don't go to a friend who's not so good at coding. Go to the guy who's best at coding. Find the guy who's good at coding. Do an online search in your college, who's the best at coding. Go make friends with them. If you want to be good at public speaking, see who is really good at public speaking and is willing to share their knowledge. Proactively find that best teacher. And that is one proven way to learn that skill faster. Now I'll pause and I want to hear from you. Do you agree, disagree, or do you have anything on top of this to add here? Suraj is saying, yes, sir, happened a lot in my school life. Competition makes a person to learn faster. Right. Competition as well as share. Teacher, see, if I'm saying somebody who is not formally your teacher, right? But they need to be willing to share. So don't go to a person who's not willing to share. That's bad competition. Don't be friends with them. Be friends with people who are good at it, who are willing to share. And you also be good at sharing, right? You also share your knowledge with them. Completely share your knowledge with them. Don't be shy. Don't be competitive. Competition will give you nothing. I promise you. In your life, competition will give you nothing. Okay? Okay. Shrankanil is saying, like maths and blessed with the best math teacher. I was not so interested in Hindi, but I became very good at Hindi and very interested in Hindi because my Hindi teacher was awesome. Right? Suraj is saying, yes, sir, happened a lot. Okay. Sumit is saying, agree to your point regarding teachers. Your point, Krishna is saying, your points are correct. Thank you. Right. But then you need to apply it in your life. Right. Yeah. Ayush, can I request you to mute yourself? Okay. So the next point that we were discussing earlier, right? So types of learning, right? So these are, I have mentioned here 6 types of learning. Again, 2 types of learning, 2 categories of learning. One is transmission of knowledge or ideas from one brain to another. Second is production of new ideas, right? So these are 6 types of learning. Reading from books. What does that mean? Like, I have some idea, I'm noting it down somewhere on a paper. On a, earlier it used to be leaf, palm leaf, right? Or on a paper. So I'm writing down my ideas. Now I'll share that paper or palm leaf with everybody and they can read that ideas. That's how an idea is transferred from my brain to your brain. For example, this webinar, I'm sharing my ideas with you, right? That's how you're learning from me, right? So one is reading, then analyzing. Analyzing is, I'm not interacting with anybody. This is what is focus, right? I'm just sitting by myself. I have some data in my head. I'm analyzing, right? And I'm producing knowledge. This is the second category. Third is doing. Like, I'm actually doing coding, making some app. I'm doing my, as part of my job, I'm sharing knowledge, right? I'm doing coding. I'm speaking publicly. I'm addressing my team, right? So that's doing. Or for you, I'm doing an experiment in the lab. I'm producing a compiler. I'm writing a compiler. That's doing, right? Fourth is discussing the thing that we are doing now. We're discussing. This is basically verbal discussion, right? I'm speaking, you're listening, you're speaking, I'm listening, and we're agreeing, disagreeing, right? Fourth is teaching. It could be, again, mixture of reading, discussing, but teaching is where, discussing is more like equal discussing. Teaching is where I am supposedly having some of a little bit more knowledge and you have today a little bit less knowledge. I am transferring my knowledge and trying to increase your knowledge, right? And maybe tomorrow you will become equal, maybe more, right? But today I am teaching you. That means I'm at a pedestal where I'm supposedly having more knowledge and I'm sharing that knowledge with you, right? So that's teaching. And sixth is ruminating. Ruminating means you have analyzed something earlier. Now you are just recollecting it, right? It's subconscious. Mostly it happens in subconscious. Maybe you must have heard, right? When Archimedes was taking a bath, he came up with the idea of buoyancy, right? Similar. So it's, you're ruminating. You're not actively analyzing, but you're recollecting your old ideas. Now, I'll pause here. I want you to tell me, what is the most inefficient way of learning? Respond to the chat box. Well, guys, we'll take 5 minutes extra today, 12:05. So what is the most inefficient way of learning out of the 6? Worst method of learning. Anybody? Yeah, ruminating is exactly that. Shankhanil, ruminating is cattle ruminate their food, but in terms of learning, this is what we mean, right? Yeah, so what is the worst? Reading, discuss, reading, right? Anybody else wants to take a stab at what is the worst form of learning? And this is important, right? Following others' footsteps. You know, Vipin, out of these six, right? Leading, discussing, analyzing, doing, teaching, ruminating. What is the worst? Actually, none. Okay. Shibudatta is giving a political answer. No, comparatively, what do you think is the most inefficient? Is what I meant. Like, I'll spend 3 hours. What is going to be the best? If I spend 3 hours on all of them, what is the exactly reading? So assuming that average visual memory. So like somebody told about visual memory, right? So assuming average visual memory, reading is the most inefficient. As in, if I read for 5 hours, I will retain the least. But still, what do we do in our daily life as a student? What do we do the most? Reading, right? So recognize that reading is the most inefficient way of learning. Next is discussing. Okay, discussing is very good. Right now we're discussing, but it's much more efficient than reading. Like, if we are spending 1 hour, right? In 1 hour, whatever amount of information that you are going to retain, If I had written the same exact same thing, you had read that in 1 hour, you would have written 10% of that, right? That more than discussing is teaching, because teaching is also discussing, but you are teaching somebody else. So if you want to learn fast coding, teach coding to somebody else. I promise you, you will learn much faster than if you're just reading a book. Don't read a book about coding. Discuss, if you want to be faster, discuss coding with somebody else. If you want to be still faster, teach somebody else. Whatever you learned, go teach to your friend. You will be much faster, right? Much faster than that is doing. If you actually do code a lot, right? You will learn really, really, really fast. Even faster than teaching, because doing is there's nothing faster, right? So reading, discussing, teaching, doing. And the last two, analyzing and ruminating, they are not really transmission methods. They are methods for production of learning, production of knowledge, right? And very tough, very, very tough. So doing, by the way, is also partially transmission, partially learning, like partially production of knowledge, new knowledge, right? Because while doing, you may know something else. Maybe you are learning cycling, but you learned how to ride a bicycle on one wheel. You learned by yourself, right? Without somebody teaching you. Similarly, doing, analyzing, and ruminating, these are methods of production of knowledge. And you need dedicated practice for that, to master this. This is a very, very difficult to master. Very, very difficult, right? You need years of practice, but it is worth it. Because Newton did it, because not forget about Newton. Even many of our friends do it also, right? They analyze, keep analyzing things, keep ruminating. Just like you, when you're solving maths problems, it gives you some different ability, which you can use that ability to create something new, to be more creative, to create something new, right? To create a solution, right? Come up with a new AI model, ML model, right? Something like that. So, but transmission, when you actually want to learn something from a book like coding or public speaking, right? So don't read about public speaking. Discuss about public speaking. What are the skills, right? Then teach, try to teach something, somebody. How do you speak publicly? You can articulate, you can speak up, you can speak from your stomach, right? So try to teach, you'll learn more. And do, when you actually go stand in front of a mic and actually start speaking publicly, that's when you learn the most, right? So I hope I'm giving you some perspective. So I want to hear your thoughts now. How many of you agree with me? How many of you disagree? And how many of you want to add something on top of what I just said? Can I hear your thoughts, please? Guys, America people record their lectures and listen to it again and again. Very good point. Shankanil is saying to me privately that America people record their lectures and listen to it again and again, just like I'm going to do with this lecture, right? See, I will tell you this lecture, but there are flaws in my style. In fact, in last lecture, there is this laptop in front of me. I was looking at the content of the laptop throughout the lecture. So I was appearing as if I'm looking down, as if I'm shy or something. Right? So I looked at my recording, I figured that totally wrong thing to do. So I'm trying to pretend to look a little bit upwards this time. I'm not sure how the experience for you guys is. But hopefully I'm looking a little bit more natural, right? So do the thing that you want to learn. Don't just learn, don't read, start discussing, start teaching. We don't teach because of competition. Like I said, competition will not give you anything. Teach, go to your fiercest competitor and teach him, right? You, because that way you will actually learn. Recognize that fact, right? So Sumit is saying—
Sir, I have a question.
Yeah, Sumit, go ahead.
Sir, whenever we have to apply for higher studies, let's say some courses are like direct PhD, where they demand that in BTech courses itself, you should have some experience of research. So, but we are not taught ever how to think about research or how to, you know, perform research. We are straight away told by...
Yeah, totally, Sumit, totally, totally with you. Nobody teaches you how to analyze things, how to focus, how to ruminate. And these are essential ingredients for research. Essential, and research you can't, like I said, analytics, ruminating and analyzing, right? These skills are acquired in years. with practice of years, and these are essential in doing research. What is meant by research? Basically, essentially research is this, that I will read things written down by 50 very bright people. I will take those ideas, I will analyze them in my head, and out of that analysis, I'll produce something beautiful, and I will share that back with the community. That is what research is, right? Essential. Now, but we are not taught the skills. Ki, how do I first of all comprehend? How do I understand all their, these are really bright minds. How do I understand or take in their ideas first? We are not taught that. He's right, Sumit is right. Second, we are not taught, once I take in, how do I analyze it critically in my mind? We are not taught that. Third, how do I produce that new result and share with the community? We are also not taught that. So totally, totally agreed with you, Sumit, that we are not taught how to do good research. It's not like we can't do it. It's just that we're not taught, we're not encouraged to do it. Right? So we are coming to a close, and Shankar is saying something to me privately. Teaching is a mixture of discussing, ruminating, doing. Agreed. So teaching, I said, is discussing, but it's also a little bit of doing. Right? Agreed. How to master analyzing and ruminating, as you said, at least takes time, but you need practice. Maybe we will have a separate session for that, Krishna. Okay? Because it's a very focused skill. How do you analyze? And like I said, there are different types of analysis. It's not like I can, let's say, analyze a mathematical formula way well, but I can't analyze an art well, right? So there are people who analyze an art well, which I can't comprehend that well, right? There are different types of analysis. But today, we'll close the session in a couple of minutes, guys. It's midnight already. Ruminating. Yeah. So SN is asking, could you please redefine ruminating? Sure. Ruminating is once you do analyze, right? Because when you're doing analysis, right, you are alone. You're focusing intensely on something. That's called analysis. But once you have focused, then you're bathing, you're sleeping, you're riding bicycle. Then that thought comes to you, right? That thought comes to you. That's called ruminating. That's why you must have, if you have not heard about Huffington, right? Arianna Huffington. She does research. So she is the founder of Huffington Post. It's a online newspaper sort of, right? That you must have heard of. So she has done very good research on sleep science, right? You learn a concept, you sleep over it. And how does that improve that concept in your mind? So definitely go ahead and listen to the TED talk by Arianna Huffington. Very recommended, right? Sleep science. That's ruminating, SN. I hope that gave you some sense of what ruminating is. Okay. Now, as a closure, right? What is the one thing that you will start doing from today as a result of this webinar? Can we all promise that one thing that we will start doing from today and write it down in the chat box? Awesome. Teaching. I am doing teaching. Okay. Ruminating. Okay. Upin is saying ruminating. Shankar is saying thinking about why. Definitely. Highly recommended. Why is the most important question of your life? Never leave that why. Shibudatta is saying doing. Definitely. Code up. Code. If you want to learn code, code. If you want to learn cycling, don't read about cycling. Don't discuss cycling. Don't teach cycling. Go do that cycling, right? Ishika is saying discussing very well. Discuss and teach. See, highly discussing is easy. Teaching is a little difficult because you need to be selfless. It's not everybody is selfless, right? But try to teach. Once you start teaching, right, you will learn. So you think you are learning from me, but I promise you, I'm also learning from you as a way of teaching, right? Coding for more hours. Awesome. Sumit is saying learning things by reading out loud and by doing. Very good. These are tangible. So when you're coming to this, my session, right? Take at least one. I'm not asking you to take five things. Take one thing. Ki bhai, Pramit taught me one thing. I'll start doing that. And I'll get back to him if that doesn't work out. I'll tell that it didn't work out for me, right? But go and try that one thing. Okay, Hiren is saying try to answer why and what. Very important. Hiren and everybody go. There is this MFL Edu Club's YouTube channel. Go watch that video on why, what, and then how. Super important. That's how you should decide what to do in life, how you can be the next Einstein or the next the great Picasso or next Mozart, right? You need, if you answer your or the next Tendulkar, if you answer your why very well, only then you can be exceptional. Otherwise not, you'll be mediocre like me, right? Saurav is saying doing, very good. Pavan is saying doing, Asan is saying doing, because we generally procrastinate, very good. Pavan is saying, can you once again, TED Talk. TED Talk by Arianna Huffington. She is the founder of Huffington Post. Suraj is saying, we'll do incessant thinking and learn forward. Very good, definitely. Okay, so as a parting mantra, this is what I, three things from my side, right? Ask yourself why you should learn. First, prerequisite for everything in your life, not just for learning, for everything you do. Am I doing the right thing by learning maths? Am I doing the right thing by learning arts? Am I doing the right thing by learning coding? Am I doing the right thing by sitting for my placements? Am I doing the right thing by learning engineering? Am I doing the right thing by coming to this webinar? And am I doing the right thing? For everything, ask a why and get a good convincing answer, right? Then search the best teacher for anything that you want to learn. It could be your friend, it could be a colleague, it could be a family member, it could be, right? But search the best teacher, because if you go to a mediocre teacher, you will get mediocre ideas, okay? If you want to be the best at IIT JEE, highly recommended, go to COA. I'm Kota. I myself did go, but that was a mistake. Always find the best teacher and go to them and learn from them, right? Very important if you want to be the best, right? And I gave an example of why Russians do the best in Maths Olympiad in my last to last video. Go watch that logic, right? Third, learn using the most effective learning techniques. Do, teach, discuss, and if none of these are available, then read. Because reading, see, reading is very easily done, right? So I'm not saying don't read. Definitely read. But if possible, try and discuss that. If possible further, try and teach that. If possible further, try and do that, right? Because doing is the hardest, by the way. Doing is the hardest, but is the most rewarding. Okay, I think that's it, guys, for today. So we will call it a session here. And if you have any follow-up question, post me in my next session or pose me a question in LinkedIn. I would just love to answer any question that you might have, or any, not just related to this topic. Feel free to reach out to me for any question or any advice that you have. Okay. Can you give your ID? Look up my name, Pramit Bhuyan. Sir, I believe there is only one Pramit
Bhuyan. I have posted the details also in the chat for the LinkedIn and our YouTube channel feedback, everything. Let me repost it.
Awesome. Yeah, Pavan, I think you can reach out to me on LinkedIn, okay? Because I don't check my Gmail ID, I rarely do. So even if you reach out to me, I don't think, it's basically pramitbhuyan@gmail.com, but I don't check it very often. Okay, guys, thank you for making it to this session and having a good discussion with me. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I hope that you enjoyed it too. And I request you to learn something from this session. Awesome. Guys, thank you. Bye-bye. Good night. See you next Saturday.
Thanks, Pramit. Thanks, everyone. And I posted the link to the YouTube channel, so you can go through it for the first two sessions of this series. Thanks, everyone.